Welcome to AICOG 2018 Bhubaneswar. I am Dr. Shahu Ingole and you are watching me live on Emcure AICOG TV. I am glad to have with me renowned gynecologist from Nagpur, Dr. Chaitanya Shembekar sir. Sir is the director for Omega Hospital Nagpur. So welcome to the show, sir. So sir, based on your recent talk in AICOG 2018, which was on endometrial scratch, does it really help in IVF? So you will agree with me that the implantation rate is low in IVF. So what could be the probable reasons, causes for the low implantation rate?
Right. See, this is a very interesting topic. And whenever we see the transfer rate in IVF cycles and compare it with the implantation rate, you'll find that you can do 99% of the IVF transfers, but still you get only 25 to 30% of success rate. And the bitter truth is that in most of the cases, even with top quality embryos, the implantation rate is low because of the problem with the endometrium. So the problem lies in the endometrium. But sometimes when I start thinking about this and I see ectopic pregnancies, I always feel that if an ectopic pregnancy can go up to 9 weeks or 10 weeks without an endometrium, then does it really require endometrium for a good implantation? But definitely the answer is yes, you need a good endometrium. Why? Because there is something called as implantation window, there are integrins, there are pinopores, there is a estrogen, there is a progesterone, and all these things they are actually adding to the implantation of the embryo in the endometrium. So endometrial factor is extremely important, and it is the most frustrating thing in IVF when you don't get a good endometrium, which is a 9mm triple line highly vascular endometrium.
Right, sir. So you know, talk sir, you mentioned about something called as endometrial scratch. So right. Can you elaborate on that, sir?
Right. See, I would like to tell you that these are the things which really matter for us. So there are so many clinicians and the practitioners who have been trying something to improve the implantation rate. And endometrial scratch is one of the procedures which is definitely going to help you in implantation. I would like to tell you some background about the endometrial scratching. Way back in 1977, some people they tried this endometrial scratching in guinea pigs. And what they found is that with endometrial scratching, you get decidualization of the endometrium, and this helps in implantation of the embryo. Now the same thing was tried by Barash et al. In 2003, and the first RCT about endometrial implantation with the help of endometrial scratching came way back in 2003. And what they found is there is a twofold increase in the implantation rate when you do endometrial scratch as compared to no scratch. Now with this, what happened that many studies and many trials they have come, and actually most of the clinicians they have started doing endometrial scratching to improve the implantation rate. Now what you need is something which is authentic, and for this you need a Cochrane database. And we got a Cochrane database, a systematic review of all the studies by the end of 2015, and 2 years back the database was there and now it is available for review. If you just look at the Cochrane database, you will find that this endometrial implantation is definitely going to help in the implantation. What they did, they actually tried to find out almost 533 studies, and they zeroed down on only 14 studies. So 14 studies all were RCTs, and these studies were evaluated properly, and the conclusion was that there is a moderate quality evidence which is in favor of endometrial scratch helping in implantation of the embryo, and a low quality evidence suggesting that there is slight pain, and this pain may be a factor which can have a little bit of inconvenience to the patient whenever you are doing endometrial scratch. Now after discussing all these studies, I would like to just tell you the procedure which is also important for the clinicians to do, when to do endometrial scratch, how to do scratching, and does it really help. So most of the studies they have done endometrial scratching from day 7 of the previous cycle to the day 7 of the stimulated cycle, means the cycle in which you are doing transfer. So a period of 1 month is included in most of the studies, and during this period they have seen that most of the studies they have used papal for endometrial scratching. You just insert the papal inside the cavity, go up to the fundus, and once you reach the fundus you just rotate it in 360 degrees. This will lead to scratching of the endometrium, and this is going to help you. Now after discussing this procedure, I must tell you that there are some points or some pitfalls which are there in all these studies. The first pitfall is that these all these studies, they are done in the stimulated cycle, and as of now there is no study where they have tried this in FETs, OR or ER cycles. Means all the FET cycles they have not been tried. Then the second pitfall is that they have not tested this with unintentional endometrial injury. Like suppose you are doing polyresection, or you are doing hysteroscopy for some other reason, or you are doing DNC. Can you compare these procedures which are unintentional endometrial injury with actual endometrial injury? Has to be studied. And considering all these pitfalls, what you need is a very good clinical trial. A trial which is going to answer all these questions. A trial which is going to give you the correct solution for improving the endometrial implantation rate. And I must say that there are two trials which are coming now, which are in offing. One of the trial is known as CRATCH trial, which is a Dutch trial. This trial, the results will be out by the end of 2018, by the end of this year. And if you just get the good results from this trial, the unique feature of this trial is they have got a large number. It is a multicentric trial with 900 patients included or recruited, 450 in age group. And not only this, they have included 200 patients where they have not only done the scratching but also done the histopathology of the endometrium to evaluate the genetic basis of the endometrium to find out what must be the cause if there is an implantation failure. So they are going a step ahead and trying to find out what is the cause behind the implantation failures, not only scratching but trying to find out the cause. And there is one more UK trial, and this UK trial is also in offing, which will be over by the end of this year, where they have tried more than 1000 cases. And if you get the results of with this trial, I am sure that you will get a correct answer. But till then, one thing is sure, that if you look at the Cochrane database, you should go on doing endometrial scratch, because there is a moderate quality evidence which says that scratch is going to help you as far as the implantation is concerned.
Right, sir. So, sir, by the end of 2018, hopefully we'll get the results of the scratch study. So, do you think that will make an impact on the current clinical practice?
Yes, sure. These are the trials which are going to have an impact, because we will get the proper direction. Since we have seen so many studies, but all these studies, they are not actually giving us the correct idea, because some of them they have used PEPL, some of them they have used EBCurate. Some of them they have used Novak Curate. So the degree of scratching, you don't know how much should be the degree of scratch. Some of them they have actually the Barash et al, who did the first trial, they did endometrial scratching 4 times in 1 month. So on 8th day, 11th day, 16th day and 22nd day. So you don't know how many scratching you should do. Only a single scratch is sufficient, or more than one scratch is required, you really don't know. So the answer to this questions we will get by the end of these trials, because they are the more wider and better trials as far as clinical trials are concerned.
Right, sir. So at the end, lastly, we would like to know your experience for endometrial scratching in IVF.
Right. So I think this is a very important question which you have asked, because everybody wants to, you know, have our own data, and we try to get our own data on what we did in our patients. So what we are doing is we are doing hysteroscopy in all our patients. And this hysteroscopy is done usually from day 20 to day 30 prior to the cycle which we are doing, that is a transfer cycle. So during this period, over the period of 10 days, we do hysteroscopy, and along with hysteroscopy we do endometrial scratch with the help of EBCurate. And this scratch, which is done with the help of EBCurate, we've got a data of around 320 patients in our setup. And the interesting thing is that we got 44% results with scratch, while we got only 37.8% results without scratch. So definitely there is the result which is in favor of endometrial scratch. But I would like to tell you one more thing which is also very important, that FETs, that is frozen embryo transfers, they are definitely good, as the improvement in the frozen embryo system is there, and you are getting good results with FET. So we did almost 120 patients in FET in last 6 months, and out of this we have not done endometrial scratch, but still we are getting almost 48% results. So that is a good part of FETs. But then I must say that there is definitely evidence which suggests that endometrial scratch helps in improvement of the implantation rate and ultimately success of IVF. Because ultimately, as we all know, the philosophy of life is karmanye madhika raste ma phaleshu kadachan. And similar is the philosophy of the IVF. You should go on doing karma and do not think of the results. Results will automatically come. And that is the take home message which I must give to all my gynecologists and IVF friends. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your views and telling us the significance of endometrial scratch in improving the implantation rate. And also, we are looking forward to a new study, that is the scratch study, which may come up in 2018.
Right.
So thank you so much.
Thank you very much.